We got to talk about a company that we spoke about on the group chat. AMD. AMD was a company that a lot of people got frustrated with, because we were talking about AMD on Market Mondays for over a year, and it was moving sideways for about 8 months. It wasn't doing anything. And, you know, people have short patience, no patience, and a lot of people sold their position. So I was in an AMD option call. I spoke about this a few times, and it went down, and I put a substantial amount of money in that option call. And then I actually dollar cost down and put more money in when it went down. A couple of weeks ago, I was down 40% on that option call. Today, I'm up 73% on that option call. So
talk heavy to him.
Patience is extremely important. But I feel like AMD, it was just a matter of time before it exploded. And we talked about this with the consolidation phase. So, you know, computer chips are, we're extremely bullish on it. SMH, one of my favorite ETFs, made a lot of money with SMH. So what are you guys' opinion on AMD? Because literally it's just like, it's just on a run right now. The last 4 days, it's just like, just took off to the upside. So how do you feel about AMD?
I think the biggest mistake that people make with a great stock is being impatient and getting out of it too early. Like, I've been at AMD since 2014. If you're a gamer, you already know how valuable AMD is. Like, at one point it was at $1.61. Now it's at $108.63. Historically, now Caleb, I'd love for you to chime in, but historically, the greatest length of time to hold a stock is a 20-year period. Especially if you're holding S&P 500, there's like a 0% chance that from the point in which you bought, it would go to zero. With tech, it's like 11.3 years. But once you have a winner, please hold on to it forever. Like, we see it now, like the Lakers are going to run LeBron into the ground and probably sign him until he's 45. But from a management or portfolio management or player management strategy, it's a great thing to do. I just feel bad for the people who got out too prematurely. But don't feel bad. We've all done it. We all have sold positions too early. But AMD, NVIDIA, Square, Apple, Microsoft, Intuitive Surgical, those are some of the ones like you should hold for a long period of time, like 10, 20-year periods. That's why I always say that a five-year period is the shortest time that you should hold any stock.
Yeah, the way I look at all of the chip stocks is chips, and I borrow this from a friend, maybe even Josh put it out there first, or our buddy JC. Semiconductors, microchips are the new transports, right? Mm. Used to be railroads, used to be, you know, cargo lines. Yeah, we still have those, but really what is traveling these days? What is moving across lines? Information, IP, right? All moving across fiber optic cables and computer servers and server farms that are all connected through chips. So whether it's for gaming, whether it's for just processing at the enterprise level, whether it's for your phone or your car, you know, we're going to need these things and they're not going away. Look at the automakers. They can't make enough cars because they don't have enough chips. So we got a supply problem there. And these companies have nothing but the capacity to make a lot of supply at a great profit margin. And I just think, like, you're right. You don't look at semis as a 3 or 4 month thing. If you want to be a cyclical trader and trade on cycles in the economy, you can do that. But if you want to be a long-term investor, think about the things you know we're going to be using 5, 10 years from now. That's a pretty good place to put your money.
Yeah. And if you look at the infrastructure of what's happening in the semiconductor world, you saw TSM is trying to build a factory in Arizona, $100 million factory. There's a company, it's crazy. I was just having this conversation when we were talking about AMD, but Global Foundries. You guys familiar?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah, Global Foundries, it was the manufacturing arm of AMD, is a right here in New York, a semiconductor company that...
I don't know that.
In my eyes, I think, well, yeah, exactly. It's one of those old babies. And potentially in the next 3 to 4 years could go public. So semiconductor world, especially in the United States, we produce such a small percentage of the world's semiconductors. And so that when you see companies like TSM come into the United States and you see AMD building factories here, it tells you like this thing is here to stay and we want to produce more of them so we don't have to pay the surcharge from getting them as an export. I'll put it in the chat, Global Foundries. You can GlobalFoundries, Global Foundries, GF.
I like what you said about chips being like the new railroad, railroads, transports.
Yeah, transports.
I like that. Because if you really think about it, that's how information is getting transported. It's not, you know, the old way of actually doing it physically is not really happening so much these days, and it's all digital. So yeah, SMH, AMD, TSM, all of those companies.
NVIDIA.
NVIDIA.
Yeah. And you mentioned the ETFs, which are a great way to access the sector. If you don't want to try to pick individual stocks, the SOX, Philly Semiconductor Index, you mentioned the other ETF earlier. Those are all great ways for investors. If they don't want to like do the research on individual stocks and follow them, expose yourself to the sector through ETFs. It's a great way to do it. And they trade like stocks.
What's your favorite ETF in that sector?
Well, I like SOX just because I've been in it for a long time. And I know those companies very well, but you could really go up and down, if, whether you want to be in the component part of it, the manufacturing component of it, like the JDs of the world. So I stick with SOX just because I built positions in it over the last 10 to 15 years. And anytime I get a chance to put money in it, I do. So that's the one I follow the closest. It's also, I think, the biggest by market cap.
That 10 years, that 20 years is amazing.